What's up guys, Sal here. So the Galaxy S9 Plus has surfaced on Geekbench and the results it posted are absolutely astonishing. The S9 Plus hit 3773 and 9024 in single core and multi-core tests, which are slightly higher than the last week's leaked Galaxy S9 scores and way higher than the Snapdragon model of the S9. So what this basically means is that the Galaxy S9 with the Exynos chips will be faster than most of this year's Android flagships, as many of them will be powered by the Snapdragon 845. So Samsung might introduce a really neat trade-in deal that might score you $350 off the price of the S9 and S9 Plus when you trade in an eligible device. That's according to a Reddit user who worked at retail and had a training session with the Galaxy S9. According to him, this sum of money will be deductible from the total S9 price no matter what device you part with, granted that Samsung will accept it. So a person who works at retail had a training session with the S9 and S9 Plus where he spent 2 hours with the devices. He posted a similar thread on Reddit like a person a week ago who had 20 minutes experience. So he says that he had this Galaxy S9 hands-on experience with the Exynos 9810 powered variant. He answered over 200 questions, but most of them we already know, so I'm just gonna go through the things that are new. He says that the user interface is pretty similar to the existing flagships, but Samsung has made some UI changes to the native camera app. You no longer have to swipe right to choose between the different camera modes. The modes are laid out on the top of the app from where users can tap to select the one they want. The live focus feature will be limited to the Galaxy S9 Plus, which features a dual camera system, and those who opt for the Galaxy S9 will have to make do with the selective focus. He also shared how 3D emoji is gonna work. Users have to create a picture of themselves, which is then created into an animated character. Once the avatar is created, the handsets make stickers and GIFs of the AR emoji that can be used across social media apps and in text messages. Another interesting feature mentioned in this thread is the live lock screen. It lets users take a short video which they can set as their lock screen. The 7-second clip will autoplay as soon as the display is turned on. One might think that this would do horrible things to the battery life, but the Reddit user claims that the Samsung trainer told them that this feature barely uses up any battery. Anyways, Samsung will launch the Galaxy S9 devices on February 25th, so we're almost there. And make sure to subscribe for daily content like this, and I'll see you guys tomorrow. Peace out.